Camera should go off.
David.
Dan disela voa fifty cent
loss
On recule les gars, on recule.
Non, il est chiant.
Nous en avons le plan, les gars.
Oh, gars.
Bring me this. I want somebody to carry this.
Thank you. personne.
Mr. Governor, we are here in front of a very sad situation. The President of the Republic, His Excellency President Paul Biya, has sent us to come and extend our heartfelt condolences to the bereaved families. And yes, he has asked us to encourage them in this very trying moment. We are all men of God, Christians, Muslims, and those who pray. It is in this building that a young Cameroonian, seven young Cameroonians were killed. And you can look at the image, the impact of the bullets. Mr. Governor, it's very important. I would like the governor to stand up. We have come here, these are seven candles representing the seven young Cameroonians who died. You can see their ages. They range from 10, 11, 12, 14, 15 years. We are asking their souls to rest in peace. And at the same time, the flames of the Holy Trinity, God Almighty, these are innocent children who have gone because they were stolen. The strength of our prayers, prayers from the Muslims, from the Catholics, from the Baptists, the Presbyterians, and all other communities, that the strength of prayers should render justice and render justice to these criminals who have killed young Cameroonians. And we have quoted the Bible. You can see three different parables in the passages in the Bible. And each has an important meaning. Vengeance belongs to God, and I am confident of the victory of good over evil. So all these devilish acts, even divine justice will catch them, as a state will follow the high instructions of President Corbyn. Investigations are ongoing, and I am sure that at the end of these investigations, these people cannot run away. They will never run away. They will never run away. They have killed innocent children. They will never run away. And this is why it was very important for us to come and visit the site, to make our prayers. And as we are leaving the candles, we are sitting here praying for them. And may their souls rest in peace. We should have gone there with some love. C'est une très haute institution de son Excellence, le président du chef de l'État, son Excellence Paul Biya, qui nous a demandé de transmettre ses condoléances, profondes condoléances, à toutes les familles endeuillées et le souhait de bon rétablissement aux enfants qui sont encore hospitalisés. Vous voyez les âges, 10 ans, 11 ans, 12, 14, 15 ans. Voilà l'impact des balles, des terroristes. Nous sommes venus ici après le deuil national. Élever les prières des Camerounais. Toutes les communautés, les chrétiens, les musulmans, les animistes, de toutes les familles. Les gens ont beaucoup prié pour ces enfants. Et que ceux qui ont tué ces enfants, ils seront comptables devant Dieu et ils seront frappés par la justice divine. Et sur terre, ils ne vont pas échapper. Parce que le chef d'État a demandé des enquêtes. Le gouverneur m'a donné quelques révélations ce matin. À la fin des enquêtes, nous promettons de très bons résultats. Mais ces enfants qui ont été brutalement arrachés à la vie par des terroristes vont payer d'une manière ou d'une autre. Non seulement ceux qui ont posé les actes, mais les commanditaires. Parce qu'il nous est revenu qu'il y a des commanditaires qui sont à l'étranger. Et ces commanditaires qui sont à l'étranger, ils seront également frappés par la justice divine. Et je le dis aujourd'hui, devant Dieu et devant les hommes. Ceux qui ont tué ces enfants, ainsi que les commanditaires, il y en a qui vont manger leur chair avant de mourir, parce qu'ils vont payer pour ces crimes. La justice, il y a la justice divine. Ils seront d'abord condamnés par la justice des hommes. Ensuite, ils seront condamnés par la justice de Dieu. Donc nous demandons à Dieu Tout-Puissant de protéger ses enfants. La nourriture des morts, c'est la prière. Ceux qui veulent aider ses enfants aujourd'hui ne peuvent aider leurs enfants qu'à travers les prières. Et c'est ce que le chef de l'État nous a demandé de faire avec son message de condoléances, avec la journée de l'aide nationale. C'est pour que nous soyons tous dans le recueillement pour accompagner ces enfants innocents à laquelle tu dois avoir qui ont été brutalement arrachés par les terroristes sans foi ni loi. Sept bougies allumées pour sept corps. Et que la puissance de ces flammes, que cette puissance agisse sur ces terroristes. Et tout qui se retrouve devient à l'instant des aveugles et des impuissants afin que notre justice puisse les retrouver depuis la vie. I want again to ask all the Christian communities, the Muslims and those faithful, those who believe in God, to pray and pray and pray, because the food of the dead is prayer. And we have to pray and pray so that their souls can be taken. But I want to tell the world here present that these crimes, you cannot commit such atrocities and go free. There is divine justice. And we strongly believe in the strength of good over evil. And coming here today, we are extending the message of condolences sent by President Paul Biya. We are extending also our prayers and putting ourselves behind the day of national mourning President Paul Biya. Tell this our children, you are innocent children, but as from today, you are with God, and God will protect you and protect your families. And the candles will remain like this. It's a novena for 9 days. After 9 days, the flames will stop. So we should pray and pray and pray that God Almighty should help the forces of law and order and give them the directives so that they can trace all the criminals who committed this atrocity. It is something unheard of. It is something unheard of. We pray again that may their soul rest in peace. Say amen.
Amen.
May their soul rest in peace.
Amen.
May their soul rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
To God be
the glory.
Prenez une avec moi et le gouverneur et vous prenez
ouvrons alors.
Ouvrons là. Rentrez,
mettez-vous la presse.
C'est
le
préfet.
On aura mis la ville. On aura mis la ville. On aura mis la ville.
Moi je suis bien là, cela vous
gagne. Je suis bien, cela vous gagne.
Je suis bien.
Keep behind so that I can have a good view.
You go ahead, just go ahead.
And the man of Cameroon, if you take a big one, which will just take the candles and message it. That can be. Are we done?
Yes, sir.
Jordan is outside.
You need to circulate faster.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
La connexion passe même.
Oui, t'as pas de
ah, voilà que tu t'en t'es foutu, même une crâne. Tiens, voilà, comme là, c'est les bananes. Et voilà, 5 minutes.
Non.
Le sac de qui là-bas? Non, c'est pas ton sac là-bas.
Nous allons accompagner ces enfants à leur dernier demeure dans un esprit de recueillement. Mais nous devons garder le courage. Nos enfants iront à l'école. C'est pour dire aux terroristes qui ne vont pas ébranler la République. Ils n'ont pas les moyens d'ébranler la République. Parce que les terroristes prêchent l'obscurantisme. Or, la République, c'est le développement, la volonté, le travail. Et puis, n'est-ce pas, le bien-être pour tout le monde. I think that we came here, this is the second time I'm coming here for less than 5 days. President Paul has taken a lot of important measures since this barbaric innocent children. After the important meeting held by the Prime Minister, Head of Government, the crisis meeting, and interministerial delegation came here, including the Minister of Territorial Administration, the Minister of Basic Information, and the Minister of Secondary Education and the Foundation of Association. After that, President Paul Biya addressed a very important message of condolences to the governor and to the Jenny families. And after that, the day of national mourning was open. So we have come here again to pray that God should help these children. The important message that we are giving is that when someone is believing, you just have to accompany the person with prayers. And that is why, as Christians, it's a novena. Look at the candles which are there. They will burn for 9 days and will have intensive prayers with the Presbyterians, with the Muslims, and all of them. And the prayers will yield fruits. I can tell you without any doubt that those perpetrators of this criminal will pay for it. Those who are here and those who are abroad. There is no hiding place from the Father of creation, who is God Almighty. There is no hiding place from the state, because we have institutions which are very, very strong. And we have to brave the difficulties and send our children to school, because the governor just gave me a report that after 2 or 3 days, the schools have resumed. We want to encourage the parents to send their children, because that is their future. That is their future. The children must go to school, and they are going to school. And many, many more security measures will be taken, so that we can always protect these children, because their future is in our hands. So, to say the least, we are confident in the victory of good over evil. We are confident in the strong one on the United States. We are confident in the future of this country. The terrorists will pay for those crimes, those who are here. They cannot escape from these atrocities. There is divine justice, and I believe in the power of divine justice. Thank you.
Okay.